why do we find it so hard, firstly, to get started with a healthy behaviour?
I think it's, as you say, it's incredibly common to get stuck in the getting started point. And the way I often think about this, and it's something that we teach physio students actually in our communications modules, is that issue where people get just paralyzed by ambivalence. And what I mean by that is most of us will know about behaviors that we should, in inverted commas, be doing, or we want to do because we know it's good for us. But we get stuck because there's lots of reasons why we can't do that. And it's this, I know I should, but I can't. And that might be because we're stuck with time, all the other stresses we have going on in our lives. And it just makes it really difficult to get started with new things.
Is it possible that naturally we've evolved over millions of years, probably living shorter lives and never really having to think about the long term. Is there maybe at some deep level we're just not wired to think so far ahead and to think about long-term survival? Is it more, are we wired more to think more in the short term?
Yeah, that's an interesting one. Quite possibly, certainly when it comes to something like physical activity, we're kind of hardwired to conserve energy in the main, if you think about the kind of hunter-gatherer starting point. And we wouldn't necessarily know where the next meal was coming from. So you'd be active to go seek your food, but then you'd be conserving energy until you were able to do that again. So yes, we're definitely probably pushing against some evolutionary kind of want to be more sedentary than active.
So getting started is one thing, and we're all not bad at times in our lives trying to get to do certain things, but it's keeping it up. It's finding it hard to sustain. Why is that so difficult?
I think, you know, there's a fairly famous quote, although no one's quite sure who that's come from, which is behavior change isn't rocket science. It's harder than that. And it's because there's such a complex, interwoven, so many factors that contribute to the way we behave day in and day out. It's not just about our willpower or our motivation. It's about our entire environment, our social structures. It's so complex. And I think, as you say, a lot of us, and, you know, a New Year's resolution is an excellent example where you think, right, this is the year that I'm going to get fit, or I'm going to change my diet, or quit smoking, or reduce my alcohol, whatever it is that's important to you. But yes, keeping up is really difficult. And it's because we are constantly pushing against our environment, particularly when it comes to being active and the diets that we consume, because our environments are just increasingly set up to make it harder for us to incorporate activity into our days, and really difficult to eat that kind of balanced diet, reducing the ultra processed foods and things like that, because our food environments just aren't set up to support it.